Change your heart, Lord, change our heart. You're living in a lawful way. Be mindful of what you say. Be sincere when you pray. Today could be your last day. Bear each other no malice. Greed and faith can coexist in the same heart.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala ashrafil mursaleen. Nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome to another live episode of The Gems of the Heart, where we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to purify our hearts, this amazing organ in our body that without its purification, there is no goodness whatsoever. This is the purpose of our life, to purify our hearts with the tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His names and attributes, to have the sound and the proper belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way we ought to, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us, and to fulfill the purpose of our life with whatever we say, whatever we do, whatever we hear and see. They're all means of purification of our hearts. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most wise, He did not leave the matter like this without making it very clear to us. Really, we have, all of us, each and every one of us, we have the chance to have a pure and complete and sound heart for us to enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's something that is in the capacity of every sane human being, but if they would follow the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to humble ourselves and to be patient, to follow the book of Allah, the Quran, and the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. You know, one of the great things that we need to really focus on, that the deen of Al-Islam, unlike the false ways of life and religions and so on, when we talk about purification of our souls, the purification of our hearts, something that all human beings would love to have, but all kinds of ideas and all kinds of distorted things that people claim that these things purify their souls and their hearts, it is all wrong and false. The only way for people to truly have a pure heart is to follow the final revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is something that is mentioned in so much details and comprehensive way. And that's why it's for people to examine and to look into this. And for the believers, they submit themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the only way for us to purify ourselves is not to try things, is not to make it difficult for ourselves, is not to follow this person or that person, but rather to follow the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the example of the life of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And the foundation of all of this is to have a sound belief, to have the proper belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him alone, not to contaminate our hearts with associating partners with Allah. And as we have been listening from one episode after the other, we're talking about the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a source of purification of our hearts, the proper belief in them, and to live our lives according to these names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that these names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when it entered our hearts and we live according to it, it's one of the great sources of purifying ourselves and to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accordingly. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, we'll talk about one of the names of Allah that is mentioned only one time in the Quran. One time is mentioned as a name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, and there are many verses in the Quran that talks about the meanings of it and the implementation of it in our life. This name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Mu'min. One of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Mu'min, the Mu'min. And of course, you probably heard this many times before. Mu'min, believer. This is how we get to know the word from the first instant when we hear it. We talk about the believers, the Mu'minun. The believers, al-mu'min is a believer. When you talk about the human beings, they are believers. And comes from it al-iman, or faith, or belief, and so on. So what does it mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His name is al-mu'min? If you look into the translation of the verses, and this verse is in Surah Al-Hashr, verse number 23, you would find some would say the bestower of faith, the bestower of security, the like of these meanings. And this is basically something that gives us an idea of what the word means. In Arabic, it's just one word, al-mu'min. But when we're trying to explain this, when we think about al-iman, al-iman or faith, and the two meanings that comes from this. First of all, who is the bestower of faith? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the meanings of al-mu'min. He is the bestower of faith. How do we know faith to start with? Who is the one that is owner of all things? When every human being, they have an idea of what the word faith means. You believe in something. You believe in what? When we say, I believe in my hands, you know, this doesn't make sense. Our hands is our hands. We see our hands. There's no such a thing of context of, I believe that, you know, I see my hands. This is very obvious. When we talk about belief, we usually talk about matters that are unseen to us. And therefore, the one that bestows, or the one that created the unseen and the seen, is who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the only way that we get to know what belief is from the creator of all things, the bestower of iman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mu'min. And therefore, one of the things that many of the disbelievers, they don't have this. And that's why it's by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have this great revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They do not understand, or they're forgetful about the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth, He won't create this magnificent creation and leave His creation like this without being guided. Guidance has to be there. And the guidance is that we see in the life of us as human beings, what happened for people to know what faith is? How do we know that there is faith? We see clearly that there are books being revealed, messengers have been sent. And this is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala communicated this faith to the human beings, and then He bestowed this faith in the heart of the believers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mu'min. First of all, the verse that talks about this name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mu'min, in Surah Al-Hashr, that says, هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون. As you see the word al-mu'min, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing is worthy of worship except Him. He is al-malik, He is the sovereign, He is the one, He is the king, He is the holy, He is the one that is free from all harm, He is al-mu'min. He's the bestower of al-iman. And this is one meaning of it again. So one of the meaning of it is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the trustworthy one, is the one that has the truth. And the truth is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For a person to know the ultimate truth, we know it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He makes the matter very clear that the truth is from Him. So basically, if you want to know the truth, you need to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He's the bestower of the truth. And where is that truth? Is in the revelation from Allah. So human beings, they can say whatever they want. Our desires, our ideas, opinions, all kinds of things that people think this is true or this is wrong, this is something that is not something that is concrete for people to understand. But when it comes to the truth, the ultimate truth, the one that knows this, the one that owns it, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why He subhanahu wa ta'ala, He makes the matter very clear and for people to see the truth. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Ali Imran, verse number 18, شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala witnesses that there is no one worthy of worship except Him, and the angels, and the people of knowledge. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just, and everything is by the justice of Allah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala witness that there is no one worthy of worship except Him. So when we say there is no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala witnessed Himself subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the best shahada, the best witness whatsoever. Nothing is more stronger than the witness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this to His messengers and to the followers of the messengers. And He aided them with ayat, with signs, with miracles that would prove the truthfulness of this. And basically, the miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aided the messengers of Allah with, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the enemies of the believers see the victory from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is how the truth is being aided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So He makes the concept, even in the heart of every single human being, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one worthy of worship. This is basically part of the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Mu'min. That when someone, the truth is explained to him, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth, therefore worship Him alone. What do you find that human being, if he's fair, if that person is not affected by the ways of the forefathers and no arrogance and so on and so forth, he would see clearly that this is the truth. There's no one worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created that in us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one that makes the matter very trustworthy, truthful, that He is the one that is the bestower of faith, and how that in this life and in the hereafter, the matter will be made clear, that the believers will be made clear that they are believers, and the disbelievers will be made clear that they are disbelievers, and therefore the believers will enter the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the disbelievers will enter the hellfire. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentioned a statement to make the meaning clear to us, which is one part of the meaning, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-musaddiq alladhi yusaddiqu as-sadiqin. He is the one that is truthful, that he makes the truthful one upon the truth by setting the witnesses and the means of evidence for their trustworthiness and the truth that they carry. Who is the one that aids the messengers of Allah with the ability to be upon the truth and to defend the truth and to implement the truth, and having the strong evidence and the clear evidence that they're upon the truth, that they can defeat all of their enemies with their speech and actions, with the establishment of the truth that they are upon. That's why when we say this religion of Islam can never be defeated when it comes to intellectuals. Nobody can defeat the deen of Allah. The arguments in the deen of Islam, the subject of the tawheed and the oneness of worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nobody can defeat that, unless arrogantly people can argue and they say all kinds of things out of arrogance. But when we're talking about arguments, when we talk about the truth versus falsehood, the matter is very clear for those who are fair and for those who use their intellect. And this is basically part of the belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mu'min. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He sent all kinds of ayat, one of which is the ayat of the Qur'an, and also the universal ayats that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, signs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent, that for people to see that the truth is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْأَفَاقِ وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show them His ayat, His signs from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the horizons throughout the east and the west, and in their own selves, till they see and they realize and the matter becomes clear to them that this is the truth. Everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created is in harmonious way that shows that the Creator is one, that the Provider is one, the owner of all things is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and therefore He's the only one worthy of worship. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is how the matter of faith has been made very clear and spread. One of the statements also by Al-Imam Sa'di rahimahullah, when he talked about the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Mu'min, he says, Al-Mu'min alladhi athna ala nafsihi bi sifat al-kamal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Mu'min, the one that praised Himself with the perfect attributes, the one that praised Himself. How do we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the revelation from Allah. How did we get to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? From the wahi revelation from Allah. When human beings, they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but they don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because they do not follow the revelation from Allah, you would find all of these distorted beliefs that people have when it comes to the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They would have similarities to the human beings, resemblance. They would associate partners with Allah. They would follow any means of misleading and deviation. They would believe that Allah has a son, or thinking of a human being as holy and things of that nature. Why? Because they did not seek the truth from the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but rather from their own desires and the whims and the whispers of the shayateen and the devils and so on. So part of the belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mu'min, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised Himself with the perfect attributes. And the perfect, basically, means of attributes and names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the beauty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the messengers of Allah and the books of Allah. The Quran is such a beautiful thing for people to see the perfect names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. and how he aided the Messenger of Allah with every verse, with every sign, with every miraculous thing to prove their truthfulness and to establish the hujjah and the evidence against all human beings by the message of the messengers. And this is basically part of the belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mu'min. So this is a meaning of it. Another meaning that comes, as the ulama they mention, and that comes from the root word of the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mu'min, that comes from it the meaning of al-aman or security. That he subhanahu wa ta'ala is the bestower of security. And when you mean about security and al-amn, in this life and in the hereafter, basically that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know that there's in the hereafter, there's severe punishment from Allah, and there is the ultimate joy in the paradise that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created for the believers. So the real security is for a person to be secure from entering the hellfire. What's the worst insecurity? What's the worst evil ever that can ever afflict a human being? Is to enter the hellfire forever. There's nothing worse than this. Nothing in this life is worse than to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be in the hellfire forever. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mu'min. He subhanahu wa ta'ala secure the human beings from entering the hellfire forever if they would follow the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he's the bestower of al-iman or faith. So he shows the matter to be very clear, and he would not treat anyone with injustice whatsoever. So if you want to be secure forever, therefore follow the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is something that one of many of the ulama they mentioned, and they referred to a statement by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, the cousin of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that when he talked about the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mu'min, he said, amina aw ammana khalqahu min an yadhlimahum, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the security or gave the security of his creation that he would never commit injustice against them. So this is more perfectly said, that don't worry, you won't be treated with injustice. Imagine this statement is being addressed to all human beings. What would you think about this? When someone would say for example a ruler, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the best example, but human beings, if a ruler comes and he rules over a country or people, whatever, and he has the means to do whatever he wants by the will of Allah. He is someone that is in charge, he has full authority, and he has power to implement whatever he wants. And he get to every single person in his domain or his country, whatever, he can get them without escaping punishment whatsoever, and he can do whatever he wants among his people. If he say to them that nobody would be treated with any injustice, and he is truthful about it, how would the people living under this rule would feel? You would never be treated unjustly. Even the slightest amount of injustice, you would never be treated with anything but the perfect justice. Doesn't that bring all kinds of happiness in this life? Of course. Who are the ones that won't like this? Are the wrongdoers, those who want to oppress others. But normal human beings, even the oppressors, they don't want to be treated with injustice. So to think of this from a human perspective, imagine that this is from the creator of the heavens and the earth. You would never be treated with injustice. That means if it happened that a person is punished in the hereafter, it's because of one's wrongdoing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most just. So this is the security, that there is the ultimate security for people in this life, that you would never be treated in the day of judgment with any wrongdoing, with any injustice whatsoever. So that means that it brings the comfort in the heart. That means for us to be steadfast, to be obedient to Allah. A person would say, but we fall into sins. We are sinners, we are weak, we are human beings. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us this way. That's why when He subhanahu wa ta'ala, He created us this way, and He warned against the punishment that He prepared in the hereafter for the sinners and the disbelievers and so on, He also gave us a great promise. And that is, if you repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before it's too late, before the moment of death, that means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts your repentance. That means that you will be secure from the punishment. If you sincerely repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and change the bad deeds with the good deeds and so on. And that's security. This is the effect of the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mu'min. And he gave that security for the believers. Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Worship him alone. Repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all of your sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you that security. This security is that you will be saved from the hellfire forever. That the hellfire would never touch you. And this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran in so many verses, giving the promise to the believers that he promised them jannat, gardens underneath which rivers flow. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he mentioned the major sins, and these sins will make the person subjected to the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, except for those who repent. Except for those who repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and believe and so on. So this is security. And the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that shows this is a fact, this is part of the basic principle in the religion of the deen of Islam, that this is also security. And that's why, if a person repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, does that mean that a person would not have any fear whatsoever of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or fearing one's sins? We still have to have the fear of Allah. And we have to fear our sins, but we have the good expectations of Allah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promise is the truth. He promised the believers that He would forgive their sins if they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in the Quran that وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُ لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. That if my slaves, they ask you about me, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I'm very near to them. So therefore, let them respond to my call. Let them respond to the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي. And let them believe in me. Believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you see how يؤمنوا in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, المؤمن. So that they will be guided. So therefore, this is a promise from Allah. This is a security from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is part of the meaning of the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mu'min. That He is near to each and every one of us with His knowledge, with His power subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's over His creation and He's near them. So that when they make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He accepts their dua. So what is the job of the human beings? To respond to the call and the revelation from Allah. To believe. To call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To supplicate. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we all have fears in our hearts, and this is something that all human beings, they have fear. We're created, we have fears in our hearts, fear of many different things. We fear death, we fear harm that happens to us in this life, to ourselves or to our loved ones and so on and so forth. We fear all kinds of things in this life. Who's the one that would give us the security from all of the fears that we have? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, since He is the owner of all things. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَى وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءُ وَيَجْعَلَكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Which means, who is the one that respond to al-muttar? Al-muttar is the one that is cornered, if it's correct to say. The one, as you see the verse here, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَى وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ وَيَجْعَلَكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ أَإِلَهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Which means al-muttar is the one that is in dire necessity. That means there is no means whatsoever. He is in a state where he is ruined for sure. He is perished, destroyed for sure, no doubt whatsoever. He has no other means in his life to think that other than being ruined and destroyed and killed and so on. In that state of dire need, who's the one that would respond to his call and his invocation when he invokes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Someone in the middle of the ocean hanging to a log of wood and he's turning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seeking help. Who's the one that would respond to him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who's the one that pushes away the harm from you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore He's the one that gives us the security from our fear. And therefore we need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what when we're talking inshallah ta'ala about the implementation of this in our life. We need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. The disbelievers, whenever they would face these necessities or these dire need in their life, they would forget about their idols that they worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we mentioned this example, he said, imagine, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect you all and protect us all from all harm. If someone is in a plane and the plane is falling, and that person, what would be present in his heart? Trust me, no doubt. Nobody at that moment, in that state, they would think of any idols or partners or human beings that they worship besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. every single human being at that moment, even the atheists, they would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, sincerely, seeking help from Him alone. They would never even think about it. It's something that by necessity will come from their own hearts. They are forced to have this. This is by necessity, and that's why those who disbelieve in the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are basically arrogant, because it's inside in each and every one of us, especially at these times of dire need. We'll continue, inshallah ta'ala. This meaning is a very important one, but we'll stop here and continue with the same thought after the break. So stay with us, inshallah ta'ala. Change your heart, Lord, change our heart.
ضرب ابن مريم مثلا إذا قومك منه يصدون وقالوا أآلهتنا خير أم هو ما ضربوه لك إلا جدلا بل هم قوم خصمون
إن هو إلا عبد أنعمنا عليه وجعلناه مثلا لبني إسرائيل ولو نشاء لجعلنا منكم ملائكة في الأرض يخلفون
ما شاء الله. We have a young viewer. How old are you, Muhammad?
11.
11. ما شاء الله. Go ahead and recite from ayah number 10. فارتقب, please.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم فارتقب يوم تأتي السماء بدخان مبين يرجى الناس هذا عذاب أليم ربنا اكشف عنا العذاب إنا مؤمنون
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم فأسر بعبادي ليلا إنكم متبعون واترك البحر رهوا واترك البحر رهوا إنهم جند مغرقون كم تركوا من جنات وعيون وزروع ومقام كريم
وتبارك الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض وما بينهما وعنده علم الساعة
This miracle was revealed over a long time span Sent from Allah to an angel then to a man That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Change your heart, Lord, change our heart.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulullah. Welcome back, and we're talking about the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Mu'min. And we see how many different things that we can think about when we talk about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Al-Mu'min, the bestower of faith, the bestower of security, and how that matters of faith, we get to know that from the revelation from Allah, and how we should humble ourselves to the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how that matters of security is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the one that bestows His security and His amn to the believers, to those who are in need of Allah. And therefore we need to change our life accordingly. And one of which is that when people are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they apply the rulings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they would have this security. They would have this in their hearts. They have this amn. They have this security in their hearts from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have the security from Allah from all kinds of miseries that people are facing on the face of earth as a result of the lack of faith and the lack of al-iman. And everybody can relate to this and everybody can see this clearly. when people are facing all kinds of depression and all kinds of worries and all kinds of concerns because of the lack of faith and iman. When people don't have patience for the sake of Allah, when people are not grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the sake of Allah, then this is basically the life of misery on the face of earth. Life is in such a way that nobody will be safe all the time from any kinds of harm or pain. We are created, life is in such a way that you have to have pain sometimes. People get wounded, people even, you know, can have diseases and so on and so forth. And if people do not have the understanding and the matter of faith in their hearts, what do? They become miserable in this life. That's why the Prophet ﷺ, he said, amazing is the affairs of the believers. عَجَبَ لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ أَمْرُهُ كُلُّهُ لَهُ خَيْرٍ. All of his affair is good for him. And this is only for the mu'min, the believers. If in أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءَ شَكَرْ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. If goodness happens to him and he's grateful to Allah, it's good for him. And if ضَرَّاءَ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءَ صَبَرْ. If harm afflicts him, he will have patience and it's better for him, it's good for him. Our life is basically either that we face what is good or we face what is harmful. And in either way, we need the patience and to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And who's the one that bestows all of this? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For those who are obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we see how in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who is the one that would give us the security, give the believers the security in the hereafter? As a result of being or worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his name Al-Mu'min in this life, the believers will have the ultimate security in the hereafter. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَلَمْ يَلْبِسُوا إِيمَانَهُمْ بِظُلْمِ أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمُ الْأَمْنِ وَهُمْ مُهْتَدُونَ. Those who believe and they did not associate any ظُلْم, any wrongdoing with their iman, and this ظُلْم is explained by the Prophet ﷺ as a shirk, associating partners with Allah, they are the ones that would have al-amn. Al-amn, the ultimate, the perfect security, and they are the guided ones. So the verse clearly states that this, the ultimate security is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the believers in the Day of Judgment, which is basically the day of Al-Faza' Al-Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala called this Day of Resurrection the Day of Al-Faza' Al-Akbar, the ultimate, the greatest faza'. Faza' is terrifying, something that is very fearful. And this is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, Surah Al-Anbiya. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the believers in that day of Al-Faza' Al-Akbar, the day that terrifies the most, the biggest terrifying thing that people would see, it's not in this life, in the hereafter. And this day is awaiting for everybody. But who's going to be secure in that day of the biggest terror whatsoever? Are the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ مِنَّ الْحُسْنَى أُولَٰئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبْعَدُونَ. That those who they received the husna and the glad tidings and the goodness, those who, the believers, they will be away from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of resurrection. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would say, لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسَهَا. They won't even hear, the hellfire and so on. وَهُمْ فِي مَشْتَهَدْ أَنفُسُهُمْ خَالِدُونَ لَا يَحْزُنُهُمُ الْفَزَعُ الْأَكْبَرِ. It would not grieve them, الْفَزَعُ الْأَكْبَرِ, the biggest terror and terrifying thing whatsoever, they will be secure from it. وَتَتَلَقَّاهُمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ هَذَا يَوْمُكُمُ الَّذِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ. The angels will receive them and would say, this is the day that you have been promised. So all of that as a result of what? As a result of al-Iman. And this is the security that the Iman brings in the heart. And who's the one that is bestower of all of this? Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the bestower of security, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the bestower of al-Iman. And see how they are strongly related. One leads to the other. If a person wants to have the state of security, the ultimate security whatsoever, then they should believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mu'min, because al-iman with faith, that leads to matters of security. And this is basically what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. And that's why we need to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The matter is very clear, really. And that's why when we talk about the names and attributes of Allah, how would that affect us in our life? With all of what we mentioned, and there are more by the way, but because of the time of the program, how that would affect our life. The name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mu'min, and we all can relate to this even if you don't understand the Arabic language, but we know al-iman, faith. We need to have that faith strong in our hearts. The faith increases and decreases. Increases with the good deeds and decreases with the bad deeds. sins decreases the iman, weakens the iman, weakens the faith in our hearts. And therefore the security will be weakened accordingly. If you want the ultimate security whatsoever, then we need to complete our faith. We need to strengthen our faith. And this is where it comes with faith, how that establishing matters of belief, establishing the salah, establishing, giving the zakah, being kind, being obedient to Allah, being away from sins, living the life that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. This is the life of security. This is the life of al-iman. And we get this from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that would lead our life in this life and in the hereafter to the ultimate security whatsoever. The goodness of this life and in the hereafter as a result in believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is al-mu'min subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another fearful moment that we all have as human beings is the moment of death. You know, you might be in state where you're healthy, wealthy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow His blessings upon all of us and to have the best of this world and the hereafter. But when we're times of health and wealth and so on, and if you're enjoying the time that you're in, you have your family with your children, with your loved ones, and whatever means of happiness that people have on the face of earth, what is the one thing that can disturb out of this moment of joy if you really, really think about it? It's death. That's why the word death, when it's mentioned in any gathering, it does not bring normally a pleasant feeling, especially that when we do not know when death will come. You know, if imagine, and I mentioned this example before, imagine people, for example, in a palace or in a beautiful place on the face of earth, and they are told, go to this place, go to this palace, go to this garden, do whatever you want, enjoy yourself in the ultimate joy that you would ever think about. But after that, death will come to you. After you finish your joy for that day, death will come and take you away. Do you think that people really will enjoy themselves? Not really. Right? Nobody will enjoy themselves in that ultimate way. This is basically what this life is. But we are, by the mercy of Allah, we tend to forget for the goodness of still to exist on the face of earth, so that we can normally live our life. And that's what the Prophet ﷺ, he said to the companions one day, لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ مَا أَعْلَمُ لَوْ If you know what I know, that you would, your life would be totally different. And that is, لَخَرَجْتُ إِلَى الصُّعَدَاتِ That means that you would go outside and you leave your dwellings. تَجْأَرُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ You would turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا تَلَذَّذْتُمْ مِنْ يَسَيْعَ الْفُرُجِ That means that you would not even enjoy your wives on your beds and so on. If you know what the Prophet ﷺ knows, that means if the unseen becomes seen, if you can see in this life what's coming ahead, our life will be totally different. But therefore, as the ulama, they say, it's part of the mercy of Allah that we do not have the reality of all things, or meaning the seeing of all of these things in the reality of the life that we live in, so that we continue to live our life. But at the same time, we know the unseen by the revelation from Allah. So our life would be just a life of forgetfulness, because there's a serious matters that are coming ahead. So therefore, when we talk about the moment of death, which is something that is inevitable, everybody will have to face this moment. This is a reality. This is not a call for us to be miserable and sad, and we watch all these types of things and we hear all of this for us to be sad and miserable. But the reality is, you will die. Everybody will die. I will die. Everybody will die. Nobody can deny the fact that we will die. And the moment of death is not a pleasant moment when a person thinks about it. But when we know and we read the revelation from Allah, it is a pleasant moment. The most fearful moment that we can think of in this life can be the most pleasurable moment if a person is a believer and do the good deeds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that in the Quran. So the most fearful moment for you becomes the most joyful one. The most joyful one. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبِشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوعَدُونَ That those who say that our Lord is Allah, and then they are in istiqama, they steadfast on the deen of Allah. قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ Prophet ﷺ, when the man came to him and he said, tell me something that I would hold fast to it, and something very simple. He said, say I believe in Allah, and then be steadfast on the deen of Allah. Tell me something that I won't ask anyone after you, O Prophet of Allah. He said, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ Believe in Allah, and then be straight, be steadfast on the deen of al-Islam. So those who they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they are steadfast in the deen of al-Islam, تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ, the angels will come down unto them at the moment of death, the most fearful moment that we all fear. And the angels will tell them two things, or three things, as the verse says, أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبِشِرُوا, which means do not fear of what's coming ahead, do not grieve of what you're leaving behind, and have the glad tidings of Jannah that you have been promised, and this is the real, the ultimate security. At that moment, the most fearful moment of death, when we think about it, why it makes you sad when you think about death? Because you're afraid of what's coming ahead. What if a person entered the hellfire? The punishment, the angels of punishment comes down onto the person, and that's a fearful thing. We also grieve for what we're leaving behind, leaving family, offsprings, leaving the joy of this life, and whether a person will enter the hellfire or not. So at that moment, the security is given for the believers, the ultimate security. No fear for that person. Imagine the state of that person. No fear for what's coming ahead. No grief for what you're leaving. Don't worry. Even the enjoyment of life that you have in this life, there's something better for you after this life. And have the glad tidings of Jannah. At that moment, as the Prophet ﷺ explained to us, this ghaib or this unseen to us, that the believer, once he receives this bishara, or this glad tidings from the angels, the believers would never want to come back to this world that we're fighting to live every second of it. The believers at the moment of death, they won't want to come back whatsoever. Except the shaheed, the martyr, he wants to come back to be martyred again because of how great honor he receives. So when we think of this and we have really the reality of it in our hearts, therefore then what is our action in this life? We should apply what's mentioned in the verse in the beginning of it. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. You believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your Lord is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then have al-istiqamah. Istiqamah, اهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ, guide us to the straight path. Live your life on the straight path. It's not a crooked one, it's a very straight path. The path of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The path of this deen, to be upon the truth and to continue to be upon the truth. Don't change, don't let the years and the time passes and you change. Years before, you were on the straight path, you were enjoying matters of faith, you were making the salah in the masjid, you were making sure that you're reading Quran, you're wearing hijab if you're a sister and so on. And then years passes and family and children, and then things are being compromised, and the hijab is being compromised, and life is being compromised with matters. That's not istiqamah. Istiqamah is to be steadfast on the truth. You know the truth, you know the way the Prophet ﷺ, and that's the importance of knowledge. And be steadfast, you will receive the ultimate security. So the most fearful moment, and that's all part of the belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mu'min. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-mu'min. That means He's the one that bestowed the security, the ultimate security is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore if He is the mu'min subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means He secures the believers that the most fearful moments whatsoever, and one of which is the moment of death. The moment of death. And therefore, turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So when we're saying the benefit of knowing the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the benefit of that is to be secure. He's the bestower of security subhanahu wa ta'ala. And therefore, the only way to attain this is to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, and even there's even more. If you want to even talk about the effect of that name to the disbelievers living on the face of earth, they are secure in their provisions. Those who are walking and talking and eating and so on, even if they are disbelieving in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if they are in the state of forgetfulness, who's the one that providing the security for them? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For what reason? For them to worship Him alone. For them to be given the time to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the message to reach them. For them to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because it's not going to be forever. So the only way for that security to continue is for people to believe and to worship Al-Mu'min, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the bestower of faith, the bestower of security. Implementing this, implementing the effect and the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is Al-Mu'min, is again our job is to increase our iman. Our job is to increase that security by being obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we're talking about this, we're talking about everything in matters of the deen. Our concern, the thing that moves us, the thing that drives us, anything that we do in our life has to be based on the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And the real joy is when a person is obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in all of one's affairs. And when we look into the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what's coming ahead of us, read the Quran and you would see that so many fearful things. There's so many fearful things that is coming ahead. We don't even know what's the next moment, the next day, the next. We're living in a world that nobody knows anything, or when the next moment will come, or what happens to it. So the ultimate security is to believe in al-mu'min, matters of al-iman, the benefit of matters of the deen. All relationships will be source of misery unless it's based on the deen, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that in the Quran. Anything that makes you happy in this life, it will be a source of misery unless it's for the sake of Allah, unless it's based on what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us. Whether it's a wife, a husband, a child, money, whether it's health, anything that we have that we like on the face of earth, if it's not used for the sake of Allah, if it does not help us to be more obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it will be a source of misery. It will bring all kinds of fear for us in this life and in the hereafter. So again, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-mu'min, that changes the entire life of the believers. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who receive the iman and are guided to the faith, and to be steadfast on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we need to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have this. And we also ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the ultimate security in this life and in the hereafter, and to make us among the people of Jannah and among those who they receive the glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the moment of death, that no fear for them for what's coming ahead, no grief for what they're leaving behind, and they will be given the glad tidings for Jannah, and therefore people would have the ultimate joy. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept our dua and to make us among those who are steadfast. Until next time, I leave you with the protection of Allah. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
You're living in a lawful way. Be mindful of what you say. Be sincere when you pray. Today could be your last day. Bear each other no malice. Greed and faith can coexist in the same heart. Change your heart.